John chapter 6, verse 67. So Jesus said to the 12, "You don't want to go away too, do you?" He's talking now to the appointed ones who would be the apostles, the 12 witnesses who would, the intention was to bring about the word of God and be those 12 witnesses, representative of like 12 tribes of Israel to usher in the New Testament and the very word, the written word of God. Judas was among them, and he would end up in the book of Acts being replaced. But something really fascinating about this question. All these people are walking away. He turns to these who are supposed to be the witnesses of the very word. He says, look, you guys aren't going to leave too, are you? And there's a Greek word in here, me, that assumes a negative response, like a no, of course not, or it's sort of almost a rhetorical, like we for sure know what the response should be. I think in English they'd be like, oh, of course you're not gonna blah blah blah. Well, then we would assume that the way that question is asked would lend a certain answer. That's how this was. Jesus is asking in such a way that they would of course say, no, we're not gonna walk away from you. Jesus also knows them. He knows in their hearts. We saw that earlier, verse 61, knowing in himself they were grumbling. He's going to know which ones were, which ones weren't. So he knows these apostles. Plus, he selected them very carefully after much prayer. And so he knows these guys. And yet, let's remember that Judas is with him, and he knows that too. We just heard that. So he turns and he's asking them point blank, are you going to walk away? There's nothing left to assumption. You're in or you're not. It's a call to decision. You know, the gospel is shared, and you're going to say yes or no. You're going to act or you're not going to act. He's not letting them be indifferent. He's calling them to a response, and he's assuming what their response should be. And so we're going to see in the next verse how they would respond.